Hello friends, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 16 to 30. This is the second part of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure 1973. Now question number 16. In non-cognizable case, the accused, option A, can object to the grant of permission under section 155(2) of CRPC as a matter of right. It is important here, as a matter of right. Option B, can object to a grant of permission under section 155(2) of CRPC with leave of leave of the magistrate. Can object to a grant of permission under subsection 2 of 55 of CRPC with leave of the High Court. And option D, has no right to participate in the proceeding and cannot object to the grant of permission under section 155(2) of CRPC. So here answer is option D. In non-cognizable case, the accused has no right to participate in the proceeding and cannot object to the grant of permission under section 155(2) of CRPC. Now question number 17. Under the scheme of criminal procedure, non-cognizable offense are public wrong, private wrong, both public and private wrong, and none of the above. So here answer is private wrong. In criminal procedure code, non-cognizable offense are private wrong. Question number 18. A magistrate has power to direct the police to investigate in respect of an offense under the Indian Penal Code, under any local or special law, both A and B, only A, not B. So here answer is option C. The magistrate have a power to direct the police officer to investigate in respect of both type of offense. Both offense belong to Indian Penal Code plus local and special law. Section 19, the leave to investigate into a cognizable offense can be granted by magistrate in any part of India, magistrate in any part of state, magistrate having jurisdiction to try case, and either A, B, C. So here answer is magistrate having a jurisdiction. A magistrate having a jurisdiction to try the case. Question number 20. In bailable offense, the bail is granted as a matter of right. It is matter of right. By the police officer, by the court, both the police officer and court. So here answer is both, by the police officer and the court. Question number 21. In bailable offense, the condition can be imposed while granting a bail by the police officer. Option B, condition can be imposed while granting bail by court. Here by police officer, here by court. No condition can be imposed while granting a bail by the police officer or by the court. And last option here, only mild condition can be imposed by court only. So here question is in bailable offense. So option C is correct here. No condition imposed while granting a bail by police officer or by court. Question number 22. The warrant case has been defined under section 2X of CRPC as a case relating to an offense. Punishable with death, imprisonment, for life or imprisonment for a term. So here option A 3 year, option B 2 year, option C 1 year, and option D 1 year but not less than 2 year. So here option B is correct, 2 year. 2 year. Question number 23. The classification of summon case and warrant case is useful to determine the trial procedure to be adopted. It is useful to determine the investigation procedure to be adopted. First here, trial procedure to be adopted. Option C. It is useful to decide the question of issuance of process to the accused. Option D. A and C. Here the classification of summon and warrant case. So there are two important points in this question. The trial procedure to be adopted belong to a summon case or warrant case are different. And option C, the useful to decide the question of issuance of process to the accused. So here answer D is correct. Now we are taking some important information about the warrant case and summon case. Here summon case is defined under section 2W of Code of Criminal Procedure, whereas warrant case is defined in 2X. So here summon is defined in 2W, and W started with warrant word here W, but its definition provided in section 2X. In summon case, the punishment is given under the Code of Criminal Procedure is up to 2 years. So which offense is punishable with the 2 years or less than is summon case, and if any offense is punishable with more than 2 years, life imprisonment or capital punishment, it is warrant case. So now charge here. In charge, in summon case there is no written charge, there is no provision of written charge, but in warrant case there is necessity of written charge. It is compulsory here. Summon case generally not very serious here, and its trial is very simple and lost short and less time and time taken and less technical. But in case of warrant, it is more serious and its trial is lengthy and it also very technical process. Where in the case of where a set of offense, and these sets belong to some cases are warrant case and some cases are summon. So whole set of cases is trial as a warrant case. Warrant case, but not vice versa. Okay. Now question number 24. Complaint as provided under section 2D of CRPC can be written only, can be oral only, either in written or oral, can be by gesture. So it is answer here option C is here, written or oral. Complaint can be written and oral. Question number 25. The complaint as provided under section 2D of CRPC can be to a police officer, can be to a magistrate, both A and B, must necessary to be magistrate only. So here answer is option D. The complaint is always before the court or magistrate, not to the police officer. Police officer given to the first information report, and which is provided in 154, but complaint provided in section 2D or section 200, the provision of there. Now question number 26. The complaint may be related to cognizable offense, non-cognizable offense, both A and B are correct. must be for a non-cognizable offense as the police has no power to investigate and such offense. So here option C is correct. Complaint may be related to cognizable offense and non-cognizable offense. Question number 27. In respect of investigation as provided under section 2EH, investigation is provided under section 2EH of CRPC. Which of the following is incorrect? The investigation can be conducted by a police officer. Investigation can be conducted by any person so authorized by a magistrate. Investigation can be conducted by a magistrate himself. Both A and B. So here option D is correct. Both A and B. Investigation defined in section 2EH of CRPC. It is conducted by the police officer to find out the evidence for the related case, and it also conducted by any person who is authorized by the magistrate, and magistrate cannot conduct the investigation himself, but he conduct inquiry. Question number 28. When a complaint is presented to a magistrate and the magistrate proceed to examine a complaint and the witness. Option A here, magistrate is conducting investigation, magistrate is conducting inquiry, magistrate is conducting trial. Option D, both B and C. So here answer is both B and C. Magistrate having a power to conduct inquiry and trial. So option D is correct. Investigation is conducted by police officer or any other person who is authorized by the magistrate. So B or C option is correct here. So here answer is D. Question number 29. The word magistrate mentioned in section 156(3) of CRPC means judicial magistrate, special executive magistrate, and executive magistrate, either A, B, or C. So here answer is option A, judicial magistrate. In this section, the magistrate instruct the police officer to start investigation. So according to a magistrate who having a power of section 190, so in section 190 they are provided two type of magistrate, first class magistrate and second class magistrate. So both are judicial magistrate, that's why answer is here judicial magistrate. Question number 30. This is the final question of this video. A metropolitan magistrate has the power to pass a sentence as provided under section 29 of CRPC. Any sentence authorized by law except a sentence of death or imprisonment for life or imprisonment for term exceeding 7 years. Option C, imprisonment for term not exceeding 3 years and fine not exceeding ₹10,000. Option D, imprisonment for a term not exceeding 1 year and fine not exceeding ₹1,000. So here answer is option C. The metropolitan magistrate have power to pass a sentence provided under section 29, that imprisonment for a term not exceeding 3 years and fine not exceeding 10,000. The metropolitan magistrates and first class magistrate the same power, having a same power, like chief metropolitan magistrate equivalent to the CJM, chief judicial magistrate. So here answer is C, 3 years. He has power to imprison 3 years and fine not exceeding 10,000. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share our videos to your friends and relatives. Thank you for watching.